And finally, another depressing poem called Climb Up and Over. And this one is actually based on my love of maps. Do you love maps?
Yeah.
Yeah, what maps you love, like they fold up right where you need to see it and crack. Yeah, I love maps, even with all this great GPS, which I also love because I'm constantly lost, or I'm constantly needing guidance, metaphor. But I love paper maps, and I kind of refuse to give up my collection of AAA triptychy kind of. Like, you don't want to give those away, right?
No.
I'm sad. Anyway, this is about maps, but it starts in Pennsylvania. I grew up in a small coal mining village in the southwest corner of Pennsylvania, right on the West Virginia border. Crazy place for an Arab family, I can tell you that. And it ends in Palestine, and you know from my bio, I've spent a lot of time there. So this is kind of motivated by these two realities, and maps. And it's called Climb Up and Over. Our garden bordered an alley which crossed into a hayfield and stretched to a hillside. Our yard had lilacs that surrounded a pond filled with sweet peas and crested by vines. Our porch led to a street that lined the road running from our house all the way to West Virginia. And we walked from one house to Neff Woods, from another to the waterfall across the bridge. The coal mining corner of Pennsylvania, with all its faults, let cows chew from this neighbor to the next, and children crossed yards that were not theirs to get to school, and sit on the steps of someone's porch without asking. And we didn't know that this was belonging. This was Pennsylvania, and not Abu Dis, where a wall was erected right down Main Street, keeping the kids away from the school they'd been going to their whole lives. So what do? They wonder. Like the farmers of Azun, whose vegetable fields, olive trees are out of reach, who stare at the 25 feet of stone and wire guarding them from their own food as a security measure that forces a 4-kilometer walk to get in a gate that gives them 20 minutes to slip over to the other side for bushels of barley to take home, if it's still there, or if you live in the Anata district in East Jerusalem, it's probably not. Some things had to move to make room for the wall. And without your home, everyone is more secure. The landscape is sliced, and the lands are carved and contained. I have studied maps. The blue waters and green mountains, yellow countries and red ones, all meant something to the cartographers, and I followed them, a puzzle of colors explained in the legend in the corner that said this was the earth. Lakes, mountains, cliffs, buttes, highways, hiking trails, one-way streets, capitals, borders, mileage counters, oceans, rivers snaking through states and countries, ranges peaking across the Urals, frozen tundra, pampas belt, thickly populated cities, railroad tracks. I run my finger along each symbol, each road designation, each color, each touchstone. How do you mark a barrier? Make it part of a landscape. What is the symbol of restraint? What is the color of confinement, disruption, loss, of separation, of sorrow? How do you hold that pen? Diagram the atlas, sketch the captivity. This is not the wall of the great march to liberation. Just a slow death to the earth that inhabits it and the people who make it home. Thank you.